इसका मतलब फिर आ जाएगी तो फिर इतना है
हेलो रामानुज। हेलो।
हेलो सर, नमस्ते सर। सर
हाँ नमस्कार नमस्कार, वेलकम।
गुड
आओ
मॉर्निंग।
मेरे
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू, गुड मॉर्निंग।
ज्वाइन दिस लेक्चर। टेल
यस सर,
यस सर। छोड़ा था यार।
10
22 टोटल।
22
सर। ओके नाइस। मिस्टर रामानुज पांडे इज एलुमनी ऑफ दिस यूनिवर्सिटी एंड ही इज प्रिंसिपल एम्बेडेड इंजीनियर फोर्टिनेट टेक्नोलॉजीज इंडिया प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। सो ही इज गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट द फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ लिनक्स। तो it is a great thing as far as the department is concerned, as far as university is concerned. For the first time in this pandemic, someone is taking class from Bangalore. So now enjoy lecture of Mr. Ramanuj Pandey.
Thank you sir.
Thank you sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
So, since we will begin fast because time is limited in this meeting. So, first of all, I would like to thank my teacher, my guru, Dr. Sushil Verma, sir. So, from last 20 years around, I know him and he is always innovative, always doing something new. Always trying new platforms, doing whatever is good for his students and department. I really draw a lot of inspiration from him, and I am really thankful that he asked me to utilize my time to do something needful for my alma mater. So we will begin this and we'll try to do something which is useful for you all. What I'm asked is to tell you Linux from you don't know anything about that. So I'm my assumption for this presentation and slide is it is for just a very beginner person. If you know already, then please bear with me. It may be just a revision for you. So what I'm trying to tell here, what my aim of this webinar is that at the end, if I'm able to generate little interest in you all, so that you are little inclined to use this as a tool, as a general purpose operating system for your day-to-day computer works, it will be a good achievement. And to add to this, I know you all are research students, if I'm not wrong. So there is a saying like, all the clever people understand much more than what is said. So I'm expecting whatever I'm telling you will understand too much from that. And end of the day, you should get an inspiration from the tool, from this technology, and you should do things your own, because that is how we learn anything. Nobody can teach you anything at all. What a best person can do is he can make some interest, generate some interest for that thing in you. So let's begin. So I will use English because most of the content is natively in English. So it would be better if we follow it in English so that there is no translation or nothing is required. So how the format is going to be, like most of the time I only will be talking. It is going to be a monologue. Dialogue will happen at the last some 4-5 minutes where you can ask your questions. In between, if you get any doubt, any questions in mind, I hope you have something to note that. And you can ask that at the end when we will have the question time in this. Okay, so let's begin. So this is a PPT which I created just today morning only, because I thought like some at the end of this discussion you should have something to relate the discussion. So pardon me if this is not complete or if it is not serving complete purpose. I tried my best. So let's start. Who are the user of computers? So from my view, or personally, I feel there are broad category wise, if we sit on top and having a bird eye view and define who are the user for computers, I see two kind of users. One kind of users are like little advanced from smartphone users. They want to do some work which is not feasible or which is not suitable for doing on smartphones, like making presentations, writing some extra long email with all attachment, this, that and all. Sometimes doing some Excel, sometimes doing some leisure things like seeing movies, seeing, singing, listening to songs. So one kind of user is this. For him, computer is just a machine. It does work, some work. And when he has to do some work, he works on computer. So a person, if he is typing, he is working on computer. So he's sitting and he's working on computer. Just keep that in mind. Second kind of people are those who make computers work for them. So suppose you have a sensor network connected somewhere, some fencing or some very small kind of appliance is there. You have a boundary wall and all the fencing is connected, all the infrared or laser, whatever fencing you have, they all are connected to a computer. And computer is automated that whenever this fencing is breached, you just ring the alarm or do something, do that and all. And after telling this to computer, the person goes on doing some other work. So what he is doing, he is making computer to do his work. So broad category is these two. One who sits on computer and does the work, and other who makes computer to do the work. Being a research student, I think you would have to do the both. So that is the advanced user of a computer. So let's see, working of computer, you can say simply example of this is like typesetting, data entry, browsing, listening music, seeing movie, etc. And making computer work is like problem solving. You have a big equation, you know how to solve, you have a generic solution, you will make computer aware of that solution, and then you will ask computer to scale. Scale means I told you how to add 2 plus 2, but now I will not limit my questions to you to 2 plus 2. I will ask 2000 plus 3599 like that. That is called a scale. Scaling the complexity, so that you can do big problems, you can make computer solve for you. You can monitor something, as I told you, your fence. You can automate certain tasks, like you can do something in your computer that every morning 5 o'clock you send some good morning WhatsApp messages to 1,000 people without you waking up and opening and typing and sending. You can do that through being a small, smart and advanced user of computer. So with this, we'll move to other next part. Actually, what is computer? So computer is a machine. Machine means something, literal word you can say, something which you can touch, feel, see. That is a machine. That is the word, hardware word is used for that in computer industry. All the hardwares are dead, like our body, like human body is dead if it doesn't have internal system, like some soul or something, whatever we say, some inherent programming which drives our body. The day that programming dies, body being there, it is of no use. So hardware is like that. It's a dead body. Software is the soul. Software enters in the body and starts managing everything of body. how much rate the heart should pump. If your arteries are fine, I will pump on 70. If your arteries are blocked, I will pump on high. So that is a high blood pressure, like that. All these things are decided by operating system. So in loose terms, when we say operating system, it's a bundle. It's not one thing. It's a bundle of so many things which are brought together and supplied in one shot. So it's like in your body also is a bundle. So many internal activities which you don't know at all. What is happening when you are eating? Which acid is secreted from your intestine or your stomach or your other organs? Liver is doing what? You don't bother. So similarly, in operating system, there are some functions which you don't bother. How memory is happened, how RAM is getting used, who is cleaning all those things, you don't bother. And some actions are there which you see, like your hand is there, you are doing something, eyes are there, you are perceiving something. Similarly, here you have Microsoft Word in case of Windows. You have some other apps which you interact with. But what down it is happening, most of the normal users don't bother. So we will say again, operating system is a bundle which compromises of two different kind of solutions. One solution is the internal, to handle internal things, which initially we don't bother. If you are a doctor, if you are a software engineer or a developer, you need to know that. So same thing. So so these are the, you can say, should have things so that person on computer can use it. So when you are selecting an operating system, you will ask, does it have a word editor? Does it has a browser? I can browse internet through it. Does it has Excel kind of application where I can do some calculation, make tables? So this is what a person who selects operating system looks for. So optionally, and this is the first one is for those people who work on computer. So this is not for those people, or it is not for of that important for those people who make computers work. So optionally, a computer or a bundle may include something, some extra goodies which will let you do your custom jobs. Custom jobs means making computer work for you. Or you can some operating system bundles, they allow you to add it later, because there are different restrictions called licenses or the money involved. So well, we will come with some examples. For Windows, if you buy Windows, you get some internal thing, internal Windows, which you don't know what they are, system.dll and all those things. And along with that, you get some utilities inbuilt, Notepad, WordPad, some music player and something. Some extra thing you buy outside, from outside that package, that is like Microsoft Office. Sometimes if you have Acrobat, Lightroom or some other Photoshop, whatever your interest is. Sometimes you buy some mathematical, MATLAB, Mathematica, all those kind of software. They are coming from outside. Similarly for all the other softwares. In contrast to this, Linux comes as a whole. Everything comes together. And what is the first and best thing why we are reading it? It comes for free. So there is no charge. You need not to pay anything. And how it helps if you need not to pay anything? Students can have their own full-fledged operating systems. Full-fledged means with everything at all, whatever you can think of today, whatever is available today. Researchers can get this. Again, why researchers? Because you are getting the complete thing. Complete means how the thing works, what are the internals, everything are for free. And similarly for universities. Universities means since all these softwares are sold on a number of users, licenses, how many will use it? So for large institutions, it becomes so much costly that they literally cannot afford. So Linux, this is the first feature of Linux. It gives you entire recipe. So entire recipe means you can see how things are working, how you can modify the things which are currently available, without reinventing the wheel. Reinventing the wheel means it's a phrase like doing things from scratch. So suppose I have some utility which does some work, but I want to just change a little bit how it shows a very simple example, you can say I have a command which when say executed, it prints the name like I am built from Fortinet Technologies. I want to change it to rename it to my name. So that you cannot do if it's a binary, but if you are getting complete thing, you can go and change it. It is made from RML Lavaji University, something. Anyway, licenses apply. This is just for an example here. So for analogy, you can see like allopathic medicine. Allopathic medicine, you know the name, you know paracetamol, you go, buy, come, you swallow the pill, it works, whatever it is meant for. But if you see like what is the component of paracetamol, I want to make paracetamol at my own home. So you cannot do that. So for that, you need to be in all those things you need to have. If you see this in contrast to Ayurvedic medicines, if you are going to buy a Chyawanprash, you know what there are inside. You know there are three ingredients. You have to take equal amount. You have to boil or you have to dry it. You have to mix them and you have Chyawanprash. Now, suppose recipe is known, but if I know the formula by which it is made, what is the benefit? If suppose someone is there, diabetic in your home, he cannot eat sugar, but still he want to use the Chyawanprash because of the loads of vitamin C it has. So he can still make that. He will not add the sugar, but he will add something which is sweetener also and which doesn't play with his blood sugar levels. So by knowing the recipe, by knowing the how it is made, if it is public, you can do so many things. So this is the same. Consider here allopathic medicine as a Windows or other binary only operating systems, and Ayurvedic medicine as Linux, where everything is with you. If you are interested, you can redesign and remake everything. So being in research, being anything considerably which requires some thinking, you have to be a power or advanced user. You have to do basic works on your machine, what everyone else does. You have to chat, you have to browse, you have to do make documents, PPTs, but still you have to do some works which is not common. So for them, Linux will always help you because it will give you plenty of examples how other people have done this. You can derive inspiration and logic from there. You can improve on top of that. So first, this was, I have distributed this presentation in three parts. First was the introduction, which I am done with. And second is how to become a normal user on Linux. And then second, last will be, I will try to explain you how you can become, start becoming advanced user. Yes. So please mute all the people because in between some sound is coming, so it is disturbing. So now we knew like why we should use Linux. So let's see how we can use Linux. So what is the best or simplest or most easy way to make it? You can Google for this if you don't know, if you are completely new. There is nothing wrong. Anyone can start. So no need to be shy in starting. So if you have a Windows machine, you can download any this virtual machine systems, VirtualBox or VMware player. And inside that you can install a Linux distribution, a type of Linux. The simplest type of Linux I would say is Ubuntu. This all, if you, these are the keyword, if you know how to ask these things on Google, like you make a string, how to install Ubuntu Linux on Windows. Then you will get all graphical tutorials done by some people who want to help others. And you can follow them and you will have Linux installed in your, even your Windows machine. So no non-destructive environment will be available to you. So it will be very clear to you, your existing things, whatever you are doing, they will be in your hand and you will start having enjoying Linux also simultaneously with Windows. So all the works which you can do on Windows, this is a very important thing you have to keep in mind. Whenever somebody says, I do this magic recipe, that can happen only on Windows. Maybe that is, but all what I would say from here, all productive work, whatever you do on Windows can be done on Linux. Some non-productive work, I consider them non-productive, you may not, like gaming or some other hi-fi video editing and all. they may not be, some particular software may not be available on Linux. So that is out of our discussion anyway. So for a researcher in physics or any other science or arts stream, you have everything in Linux for free without any license, which you get in Windows by paying money, by buying license. How to do that certain things? You can always be a, see, our civilization is a question-based civilization. If you read any our scriptures or anything, all the knowledge is transferred on question. Somebody asked someone something. You also learn to ask. Nowadays, you should learn to ask Google how I should make the very crisp questions to Google, which give me the very apt results. This is not one day process. You keep on doing. If you learn how to ask questions, it will help you too much in your research also. So next is any new work you start. So initially people have enthusiasm, but after going some distance, some 5 days, 10 days, they feel like, why the hell I'm doing this? Anyway, I can do this thing on that different one. So why I'm doing this thing? So what I would say, don't lose your heart. Just consider a situation. You are not changing your mobile OS. You are still on Android, but when you shift from one to other brand, you find trouble in finding the options where to record the sound, where to do this thing and that thing. Even like switching from Samsung to Xiaomi, you will find issues. So they are initial days issues only. After some time, you will be adjusted. If you want to cross the river, you have to bear with the middle part of the river where flow is very strong. After that, on the both banks, flow is very normal. You can easily cross. So let's see how we can interact with machine. Machine means computer. So what it's a, you can say a proper name of computers, calling them machine. So let's see how we can interact with machine and which ways are optimal, which ways are perfect ways to interact. So the thing perfect is never perfect. So it's always relative. So when I'm saying perfect, I'm saying perfect for the kind of job you are supposed to do for next whatever research tenure you have. So what is the perfect way for you doing this work? It may not be true for a person who is doing desktop publishing work, sitting and typing whole day. So it is not perfect for him. So there are mostly, on an average, 4 ways to interact with a machine. You can interact with using a keyboard, means writing something in machine, and machine will write you back. You say hi, machine will return you hi. So like that. So nowadays you type so many things. And mostly where you type those commands, that commands are called as, that place is called as command line interface. Since you interface, you attach with the machine through a line, command line, where it takes command, it is called as command line interface. So some interfaces are where you attach to machine through some UI. UI means user interface, where you see things and do. So like a web browser where you see and click things, like some Microsoft Word and all, you have to say bold, you can do by CLI or the keyboard also, Control B, or you can select the passage which you want to make bold and you can find a place where B is written and click there. So second way of interacting is this. So any system which you are using where click is the way of interacting, you cannot say that I will not use keyboard. Still you have to use keyboard. Then third and populist one is the touching. So nowadays everything is becoming touch. Laptops are becoming touch screen. People who work too much on mobile, they when they come and open laptop, they start touching them. And then they feel, no, this doesn't work. So even in touching also, whatever advanced technology or easy technology it is, sometimes you need to use keyboard. Maybe it is virtual, but you need to use keyboard for typing. Then fourth and a very interesting thing nowadays coming is the natural human language based interaction. Like I will speak to my computer and computer will speak back. So this is a good field of research, natural language processing. So, but it is still under development. It is not perfected as of now to be made a general recommendation for the users. So among these four, which one you will prefer or which one has benefits? So from my view, from your view, I will try to say. So if you see here, when you are using command line access or you are typing commands and on computer and computer is returning you back, then you don't move your hand anywhere else apart from keyboard. So you are not disturbed by touching mouse, clicking and coming back to again keyboard. Like that you are not doing. Since most of the jobs in research or in software development are mental works, you have to concentrate, you have to focus. So any kind of distraction is always not recommended. So for an example, see one poet is there who is in some thought, he's thinking about some plot, some scene, some character. He would like to be in that thought only. He would not do anything which brings him out from that thought, any physical or mental movement. Similarly, when you are working on computer, solving some problem, writing, debugging, then you would not try to when you will not try to deviate your thoughts to somewhere else. So same is a programmer or somebody who is making computer solve his problem. He will not try to distract himself. So that is why most of the people prefer CLI. So if you see, especially if you see some Hollywood movies or some serious presentations which are by some scientists or some hackers on YouTube or anywhere, you will see mostly they are working on some commands. They are writing something and computer is writing back with a million lines, is scrolling very fast. It is not only to show you, but it is also very efficient. Once you will start using it, then you will feel that how productive you are when you are doing things in command line and you are not worrying about clicking, dragging, dropping here and there. But it does not apply to all kind of work. Few works are which cannot be done on command line. So this applies to our kind of work, what you are supposed to do going forward and what I am telling you. So you can see this all PPT. Also, I did it without seeing how it will look because I wrote in a command or a text-based engine and then I gave it to my compiler, like compile and make it a PPT. It made it. I need not to worry where it is board, how the spaces between this is set. This all my program has taken care to generate it. So that way you can see even making PPT can be done without using mouse or clicking or those things. So with this, let's enter in the world of Linux user. So one thing I'm very fond of, again, our scriptures or our civilization, like we tell all the serious and very tough concepts through stories, through some analogies. So at the end, you have a interesting story also. And from story, you got the moral or whatever need to be communicated, that also you got. So we also will try to wander in this Linux through some analogy or kind of story. So let's consider there is a jungle. The jungle is named Linux. It's a big jungle. You don't know anything about that. You heard like somewhere there is a jungle and you know, like if you see certain thing, you will figure out like, oh, this jungle is Linux. So suppose somehow in your dream or somehow you are dropped into that jungle. And now you are waking up. So you just woke up and you saw like you were sleeping or you were unconscious. So the first question anyone will ask, like, where am I? So similarly, you can see when you are logged in a Linux system and you are trying to figure out like where the hell this fellow kept me, all black, only some letters are there, something blinking. There is nothing to click. There are things to click, but as of now, consider there is nothing to click. So how the hell I will figure out where I landed? So that is the first question. So when you log into a command line interface of Linux, this is the first question you also will get. How to figure out in this whole Linux system box or software where I am? So let's try to find out how you will solve this thing. So first you will try to see which kind of forest you are. So you will look for the things around you and try to see if you know them. So there is a this string you can see. String is a sequence of character. So anything is a string. So this is sequence of character. So you can say like this is a string. So you can see Ramanuj at Ramanuj virtual box, colon, tilde and dollar. So since I am assuming you already knew this forest before and you already know something about this forest, not much. So by seeing this, you should understand or you should get a feeling you are in a forest named Linux. Because in Linux only this kind of thing comes. This is just for simplification of our discussion. So now you again know, like if you are in Linux, how to see where you are, what things are around you. So there is a command called ls. You will run this command and you will see like these are the things around you. So it is very obvious since you know many forests and you didn't pay attention while listening to Linux forest. So you may forget like what all were the intricacies of ls, what is the details ls has, how to see this thing, that thing. So in turn, you need a manual. So you will ask yourself, do we have any manual of this jungle? How to handle things in this jungle? Like if you are in a normal jungle, the forest department give you the manual. So like if you go in any tiger reserve, the moment you enter in the reserve, they will tell this distance you have to cross in 20 minutes. Time I will note here at the exit, that fellow will note the time again. They want to know like you are not driving very fast or you are not stopping like that. So similarly, you also will look for a manual. So yes, Linux Forest gives you a manual. The manual is short of manual, that is man. So ls is a tool which will tell you what are the things around you, and to know what is the details of this tool, you can say manual ls. So instead of saying big manual, there is a command say man ls. You do this, it will tell you the specification of ls. So let's try to do this much and see if I'm on the right track. So I hope the size of the screen is not so small. It is visible at your side. If it is not, I can zoom a little. Any one person can tell me. Okay. So this is what I said. So this is the thing which is Linux is giving you. So by this, I know that this thing looks like a Linux. I will do a command I know from my last interaction or reading of Linux, like this is ls. So I will do this. It is telling these are the things around you. So this is something 1.py, something delmi, something like this. So in this forest, at least one thing I came to know, my older knowledge told me, like when you are in this, you do ls, it will tell what are the things you are in between to them. Now I forgot how to use it in further enhanced details. So I will ask for a manual, man, ls. So now this is giving me a manual. So if you have to do anything, suppose you are in a thin film research, you have to operate some particular nanometer or something, you cannot just go and switch on buttons and start putting something. You have to read the manuals. If you are really interested in utilizing that particular instrument at the fullest. So, but few features which are not required, you will be omitting. Like I don't need to measure this thing, so I will not read it today. So similarly, you can come here, you can start looking like what it is telling. So if you say minus A in front of me, I will show everything. I will not ignore any entries. So like that you can read. And yes, so now you have to close the manual. So closing the manual, you should be a very keen reader and you should keep your mind here only when you are working here. So you see here it is telling manual is line 23, press H for help or Q. Q is small q for quit. So we'll put a small q. So manual disappeared. So with this again, we will come back here. So now what we are interested in, what are the things behind me? So where I am, now I need to gaze like what is the depth I am in? I want to know what are the things behind me. So again, how I will do, I will say ls this is a representation, two dots for behind. And you see behind me a place called as Ramanuj. So what is in front of me? I know what is my place is this. What is behind me? Now I know this. If I have to say what is inside this container, so I will say LS this. And you can say in Delmi there are things like this. Now I need to know what are these things. I'm logging in for first time. I don't know what actually these things are. So there is again a command for this. How you will come to know for these commands? Google, just Google, make your questions. I want to know what type of file is this, or I want to know this and that. So I want to know which tux.png is what. So I will say file this. So it is telling me now, this is a PNG image and it's a data. Size of this is 280 into this. 8-bit colors are used and it is not interlaced. Suppose I want to know what this file is, new.txt. I will say this and it will tell me again, it's a LaTeX 2E second edition document encoded in UTF-8. So all the things you need not to know, but whatever you are interested, you can still Google. Try to use Google for any and everything to understand. Don't let Google make decisions for you. Let Google work as a tool for you. So now other one I am looking with, what is this .py? So it is telling it's a Python script, ASCII text executable. So next I am looking, what is this file for me? It is telling it's a PDF document version 1.5. It doesn't matter that extension is PDF or not. If I move this new.pdf and I say this name as a something which doesn't have PDF, so Delmi old, and if I say file this, it will still figure out that this is a PDF document. Yeah, there is no .pdf at the end because this program goes into that file and tries to read what is written inside. So I hope now with this you can figure out where you are and what is the thing behind you, how to inquire what are the things around me, what is their type, so that you are familiar with the place you are dropped in this jungle. So you can see containers, what they are containing, directories and all. You can do ls and you can use file to see what type of things are they. Suppose you are interested in all Python kind of scripts, you can go and see like which files are Python files. So let's discuss more about this jungle. So this jungle is a, like a tree which is having roots in the sky and leaves are at the end. So it's an inverted tree structure where you are landed. So what is the root? Let's go to that root. And what will be the, what is the best definition for anything starting? So in like in Sanskrit, they say Adihi. So what is the definition of Adi? So beyond which there is nothing is called as Adi. So we also will try to do the same thing. We know already like how to go back. So we will go back and see how back we can go. So we are going back is Ramanuj. Again, we are separating. This is a separator and again going back. So we came here. Then again, we are trying to go back. So we are still at the same place. So where we are coming, this two place is the last place. It's the root of inverted tree. So I will do another command. What it does, you can see in later. So now you can see you are at the root. This slash is telling you are at the root. So from starting from here, your tree grows and it tree grows very deep. All the branches doesn't grow same. Some branches are very deep and some branches are very shallow. So that we will anyway figure out and you will, when you are practicing, you will see. So let's follow our presentation so that it is easy to relate. So that is the place. Single forward slash is the place beyond which you cannot go. So that place is the root of this inverted tree. Now you have to learn how you traverse in this forest, how you can go different places, how you do in any click based system. You keep on clicking that folder, this folder, and you are moving. But here you, it is not that way. You have to traverse through commands only. So that we need to know. So let's see how to traverse. So before that, I will tell you these two things. Absolute path. So there is a concept called absolute path. Absolute path means a path starting from root, of the tree. Everything is clear. Second way of addressing is telling the path is from this place, where is the thing? So it is, say, in daily life also we behave this way. So suppose if you know somebody is, if somebody is asking how to know how to go to Gulabwadi, so you can simply say, okay, there are two ways to tell. If you know his home, then you will say, okay, you live in Saadatganj. So you start from there, go to Chowk, then keep on going straight or something like that. Suppose the person, when he is asking you, then at that time he is standing in Chowk itself, what you will say? Nothing, man, it's very near. You just take this road, it goes directly there. So first one is called as absolute path. Direct from beginning, what is the path? Second one is called as relative path. Relative to whom? Relative to the place where you are currently standing. So again, let's practice that also. This all you will practice later. I will give a link where you can get the document and practice your own. But just for completeness of this presentation, I am doing myself. So you can see here, I am saying LS, and this is the PWD, presently where I am, present working directory. It is in /home/Ramanuj. So when you are saying LS, you are giving the relative path. Where I am standing, you display that one only. Same thing you can do with /home/Ramanuj. This is the absolute path. Both should be same. Both are coming same here. Suppose there is a file like /home/Ramanuj/new.s. So this is the complete path, starting from this first root till the end. So end is called as leaf and beginning is called as root. In between things, you can assume stem or branch or something. So now you are accessing this leaf through absolute path. Suppose if you have to do ls new dot s, you know that this place is at this path only, near the place where I am standing. So this is I can list this thing from here only without giving any further path. So similarly, suppose there is in delmi I have a file new dot text. I want to address this file through absolute path. I can say home Ramanuj, then delmi, then new dot text, and do list you will get. And since I am standing at home Ramanuj currently, I can say from here, from home Ramanuj, go through delmi, from there you will reach to new dot text. There are so many millions of commands which you can follow. So okay, it is not installed. So initially for doing these works, this is the simplest way. So after presentation, you if you have things installed, you can, if you don't know already, then you can start just traversing, just for fun. Keep on going and figuring out how you are able to access a path, how you are able to reach, how you can search and all. So okay, so there is again a concept which says, in Unix, everything is abstract. It's like a secular country. So any person's religion doesn't matter. So Unix or Linux says everything is a file. So if everything is a file, then this ls command should also be file. But ls command is not shown in the place where I am currently standing. So how the ls command is coming and executing? So this is the question. This is the jigyasa. If you are asking this question, then you will get the answer. You ask this question to Google, it will tell you. So there is a way, there is another command to tell where a command is, that is which. So when you will say which ls, so it will tell ls from root, there is a stem called bin. Inside that, there is a leaf called ls. That ls is ls when you will type here. So let's validate through the absolute path also. Is it there? Yes, it is there. So I want to know how big it is and what other details. So there is a flag which you can figure out from manual page. So minus L, if you add, it will tell this is are the something, this is something, this is something, this is this. So many extra information. This you can decode going on, as of now not required. So So now you know that LS is coming from a different path. So another question you can immediately ask, okay, but I didn't told him like you go and search in slash bin stem, how it went there and searching. So few things are prepared for you on your arrival. So some paths are searched, set for you, you can see. So when you will write anything, these are the standard locations which will be searched. So like this place, all separated by these double dots. So if you write anything, if suppose I write Ramanuj, so it is telling command not found. Before telling you that this command not found, he searched this command at this place, at this place, at this place, at this place, and till the end. In all these places, the command, it was not there. After that, it is telling command is not found. So hope this concept is understood. So now with this much knowledge, since my time is limited, if you people are interested, we can have another sessions going forward on specific topics. But since today's session is very generic and my time is limited, so I will not be jumping so much my own. So what I'm asking you, run means you access path very fast, walk, jump, jog in Linux forest. Don't forget to see what things are there, in which places you are not allowed to go. So I will do one example for this. Can you mute please? So suppose now you are doing LS.
Hey, tiffin.
And
tiffin.
So I wanted to see, I went here slash and I am seeing there is a place called ETC. I would like to see what this place ETC has. Oh, this has so many things. So I am interested in what this place, what this issue file has. So I will say, okay, what kind of thing is this? So this is where to move.
चला सब घरे खाए ले जाना है चला खड़ी के घरे खाए ले चला
ओके सो आई न्यू लाइक ओके आई वांटेड टू नो व्हाट दिस इशू इज सो इट इज टेलिंग इट्स अ फाइल सो आस्की टेक्स्ट ओके नॉट इंटरेस्टेड आई वांट टू नो व्हाट दिस नेट प्लान थिंग इज जस्ट लाइक दिस यू गो सो इट इज टेलिंग ओ इट्स जस्ट अ डायरेक्टरी मींस इट्स अ प्लेस होल्डर राइट. So this way, what I meant from this sentence was this, like you run, walk, jump, jog, you go anywhere and try to see like what are the things are there in this this Linux forest. So now after jumping, you are tired. So you have seen enough in this thing and how the thing is organized. This all I'm leaving it to you. You just go figure out why ETC is a different place, why home is a different place. There should be some logic behind it. Read your own and try to understand. This all is very interesting. And it will not help you only in understanding Linux or using Linux, but it will help you also in doing or organizing your work. How to keep your documents. So suppose you are making some documents, some test results, some thesis, some paper, something, how to organize that. You can see from here, this is the most well-organized thing, which is running from last, I think 1970s onwards. So you can get an idea which you can use in organizing your thing. So just exercise, just go wander in itself. So while wandering, there is a person, Tab. So I have written Mr. Tab. So Tab is your Tab button. So suppose you don't know where the place after one place where you have to go. So suppose I say like Del Me. I don't know now after this what is the place. So you just press Tab for two times. So Mr. Tab will tell you what is inside. You can see. So Tab is always very helpful when you are navigating on command line. So now next question will come to your mind. Now just recall what is our situation. We were sleeping or we were dropped in a forest. We first figured out or came to know about our place, which place I am in, what are the containers. There are so many things around me, what is inside them, what is behind me, how to go forward, everything you came to know. Now you are a little bit familiar with the place. Now what you want to know that who am I actually, who am I in this place? So to know that who currently you are, there is a again a command. All these commands are written. I can simply either see from here, like who am I? I am Ramanuj, or I can use a command ID. So ID is like your any college ID or any ID. So it is telling user ID is this, group ID is this, these many groups I am member of, you can see. So this all is all information you can use for that. Similarly, now you are interested in socializing. You want to know, is there any other people also in this forest? So you want to see like what are the other people? So there is a command for that, W. So W, it is telling like there are two people in this, both are Ramanuj from different places. You are landed in this from two different places in, you can say, clone or something. And the same is who. There are two commands. So you can say from what time you are landed. So this is the place where you are landed. What is the interaction? This is the date when you landed. This is the time. So now the question, immediate question you should get in the mind. If you are using Windows, you know, like if you are using, you only are using. So, but how you are asking like there are other people in this jungle. So in my Linux, in my workstation or in my laptop, I only will work, right? Why other people will work? So that the question you should ask. So thing is, can many people work in a machine together? So that is the other way of asking it. Then normally initially you should get a doubt, only one keyboard is there, only one screen is there, how other person will work into this, and what is the point, since it is a single user system, what is the point making other person work into this? So for that there is a concept called multi-user system. Linux are from beginning, they are multi-user system. At a time in your machine, one machine, thousands of people, depending on strength of your machine, which processor, RAM and power it has, thousands of people can work together. So that is called as multi-user system. How those people come here and how they land into your machine is called as internet or net or network. So when you access gmail.com, you actually landed up in some machine in US or Singapore, whatever form you are redirected to. And now that machine is talking to you. He is giving you some web page, showing you Google Doodle, and then you are writing something and it is returning. You are actually talking to that particular machine. But Google have not reserved a machine for you only. So there are millions of customers like you. It cannot be reserved for each customer one machine to talk. So what happens? Every machine serves many customers. So similarly, it is a VM or hardware, your machine, Linux machine, can also have multiple logins. Multiple people can be in your machine. That is why you need to know this thing, who all else are in my forest. In forest, all will not be good people. Some people will be good people, some people will be bad people. So bad people are like hackers, like your Trojan horses, some security related things. Good people are like, suppose your teacher is helping you to fix something in your machine by logging in from his machine. So they are good people. They are helping you currently. So by this, the first part I will summarize. With this, I expect like you will have some interest in this jungle and you will try to traverse more. You will try to see how multiple user will come. And for everything, there is a manual, online manual, a copy with you and a Google. So everything, you have to start thinking. And when you will start thinking, everything will come in place. So that is what I said here. Keep asking questions to Google, to teachers, to fellow travelers, to explore. This will teach you two things. First, how to do that particular operation in Linux. Second thing, how to ask right questions. When you will ask wrong questions, you will get wrong answers. Then you will again go back and relook. That feedback will tell you your question was not correct. You will reframe your question and the answer giver also will reframe his answer. In this exercise, someday after some 6 months or something, you will learn an art of asking questions to humans and to machines. So at that moment, you will see most of the work is already done by somebody else and you will feel sometime like what is this, any there is there no new things to left to do to be done for me? That kind of feeling you will get. That powerful questioning is, if you question right things, most of your doubts, your queries are already answered. With this, we are entering in the world where the computer is going to work on your command. So the way you will tell, computer will work that way, or you will use the computer. Again, we will keep the same analogy. So like our jungle thing. So now we are talking to Linux. So now I'm talking to this jungle. We are talking to this jungle to get some work out of it. So first question is, how you will talk? So is there a reception or is there some help window in this jungle where I can interact with this system? So to interact with system, one way of interaction was the commands you used till now. But those interactions were predefined. So it is like you go to that window, you press that button, insert coin, you will get a ticket. It is not some human setting which can answer your questions, your custom queries. So now the person in jungle wants somebody interactive to whom or to her, he or she can interact and ask questions. So there we need some kind of programming. So I'm just giving you a glimpse. You may be already well aware of programming. So, but since it is my scope of discussion, so I'm giving. So I'm using a tool to communicate or a window in jungle, which is that window is labeled as Python. So how I choose that window? Because to communicate to anyone, you need to know his language and he need to know your language. Suppose you landed in Bangalore and at airport there are four windows. One is written strictly Kannada, other is written English, other is written Hindi. So now which window you will go? If you are not flaunting yourself or showcasing, you will go to your native language window. I will go to Hindi because that is the language which I know. So that is how I choose my window. So similarly, when you have to interact with the Linux jungle or your computer, you will select the way you know and the way your Linux knows. Both should know that thing to interact with. So Python is also known by Linux. Python is as a language is known by me. So I will use Python to interact. So second thing is how to know you are at that window. So there is a symbol like this, three greater than brackets, angular brackets, greater, greater, greater. When you see this symbol, you will understand, okay, I am at the proper window. So let's see how to get this symbol in your Linux. I will write Python 3 and enter, and I got this symbol. It means now my Python jungle has opened window where he will let me communicate with him in Python. So now I'm happy since I can communicate with the system and I can make system work for me, or I can ask system to solve my problems. They are very simple problems I have taken. All intention is to make you comfortable and make you interested if you don't know already. Okay, so I got a window. I am excited. I just want to do some small things with this just to test like this works or not. So I'm asking the jungle, oh jungle, can you repeat these name what I'm telling? So that window, Python window, I'm asking, can you please repeat these names? So how to tell this thing to jungle is this statement, print this. So let's see if jungle can repeat this thing. So I'm telling print is the way of telling repeat in the Python language. I am telling repeat, say the names are, any names are there. Ravin, Sudha, and say Bhavya. So I'm telling window. I'm just testing before giving it some meaningful work. I'm testing. Can you repeat these names for me? He said, yeah, I can. And he repeated. See, the names are Sunil, Ravin, Sudha, and Bhavya. Okay. Then I'm further happy. Then I said, okay, let me test it further. So I will say, good, jungle, you remember these names. Now remember these names and tell me when I ask. So now I want to test the jungle memory. I am telling, now don't repeat when I say, you remember this name. So whenever I will not ask you now, but whenever I will ask you, you have to reply me. So to remember, I have a different way of telling remember. That is, I am telling new equal to. This is the equivalent of saying in English, remember. I said it and he said nothing. It means he remembered because he doesn't speak unnecessary. Again, I know already, like when we have to ask, we have to use this one. So I am asking him, hey, tell me what you remembered in new. He will tell, I remembered Sunil, Ravin, Sudha, Bhavya. Again, I will ask, what do you remember in this? He will again tell the same thing. I will ask 1,000 times. He will tell 1,000 times. It means it has memory. Anything you want to save, it will remember. Next, see, again, my curiosity is grown. I want to know like what else he can do. Now I'm again making fun. I'm telling all the names you have, jungle. Can you add Sri in front of him so that some respect is shown? So let's see how you have to tell and how it can tell. When you are telling for everyone, you will say for. For whom, you will write first. Whom. In what? What is the from which memory I have to tell? I say new. New is a memory you have in which you have already some names. Now from that name, you tell me names of add the Shri in everyone's name. So I will say when you are telling me same thing, that way of telling is print. I will tell say Shri, Shri. And the person name. So, and that's it. I want my this window to, I already told him names. I want every name should be appended with Shri so that respect is there. Let's see if it is able to do it. So see, simply you just told him he is able to do this thing. Shri Sunil, Shri Ravin, Shri Sudha, Shri Bhavya. Now my desire is increasing. I am saying, oh, it is a good thing to play with. Let's play further. So what I want to play further? Let's see what we have here. So now you have seen like there are some names which are of ladies or girls or feminine. So I don't want to add Shri in front of them. I want to add Sushri in front of them. So let's ask my window again. So I will say, oh window, whatever names you have, in those names, can you add Sushri for all the lady names? So when, if you are communicating to somebody, you should know, you should communicate it clearly. So computer will definitely ask, what is a lady name, man? I don't know any lady name. So I am telling him, so whatever name you have, if the last letter of that name is ending in A, because most of Indian girls or ladies' name ends in A. So then as of now, you consider it's a lady. So again, I'm telling, when you found a name at the end called A, then you, instead of adding Shri, you add the Sushri. So this is the way I told him. And I'm telling like, if anyway, if it is not ending in A, anyway, you will keep on doing the older thing, what you were doing. What older thing was there? You were adding the name of Shri in the name. So there is one mistake. Just give me a second. So now you can see this fellow is intelligent. Whatever you will tell him, he will do that. But only one thing is there. You should be very clear in telling him. So now you see it is telling Shri Sunil, Shri Ravin, Sushri Sudha, Sushri Bhavya, like this. So this is a useful machine. So again, you are in playful mood. You are asking, okay, tell me what you remembered. So it will tell, okay, I remembered this this thing, Sunil, Ravin, Sudha, Bhavya. Now you can ask, okay, in the list, whatever you remembered, who is the second person? So it will tell second is Sudha because his counting starts from zero. Still you are in playful mood. You are asking, what is the first letter in Sudha. So it will tell first letter is S in Sudha. Again, you want, okay, this is capital. I want it to be in small case. So, okay, I need to install that. To lower, I need to bring that. Okay. So this way you can interact with this fellow and it will keep on answering you. So this is just an example. If you find interest, you can do all your problems through this fellow, this window. This jungle in backside is very powerful. It will solve all your problems. Okay, let's move to some, now in our place, people say, if you don't know math, then you don't know anything. So let's see if our jungle knows some math. So jungle knows the basic maths. He knows how to add, how to subtract, how to divide, how to multiply, how to do remainder. All combinations you have to make. How you can give a tough problem to this jungle. So let's, first tough problem, I will say, okay, I am not burdening you. Can you add numbers from 0 to 10 for me? So I will say for I in 0 to 11 because it reads one number less. And I am saying, okay. So I am making a place where the result will be stored. I am telling, can you add this thing for me? And then I am telling sum. This, don't worry about these things. This you have to learn. You have to learn the language, and this language is very easy and simple. That we will see how we can learn it. So I told him, like, you add everything. He said, yes, I added. So now I said, okay, you added, then tell me the answer. So it is telling 55. 55 is the answer. So now you can just be a little jolly. So you told him the clear logic, how to add the number. Now you can think, adding 10, I also can do, maybe not as fast as you. What special in this? So now jungle says, I can add any number. So I want to add till 10,000, 0 to 10,000. What you need to do? I will do the same thing, nothing else. Because once you told me, I know. So see, if you add 10,000 number, a simple program like this can add this. When you are doing this, then you are making computer work for you, making computer solve your problem. You are not working on computer, or you are working on computer also, but making computer solve your problem. So this is the, I would say, advanced use of computers. And this is, of course, this is programming. So these I have added. So now with this example, you can see how things can be, how computer can do. Computers strong or positives or pros are that it can do lightning fast. It can do very good accurate calculations. And its cons or drawbacks, you can say it is a dumb fellow. It need to be told explicitly clear. Nothing from like in human communication we say, right? Sometime we smile and that means a word, like I accept it. Sometimes we shrink our eyebrows, it means no, I'm not happy. So that way of communication will not happen with computers. It need to be clear and straightforward. So if you are able to communicate, computer can do wonders for you. So that's it I had for this first discussion. If interest or if curriculum, your curriculum permits, we will build on top of this. So initially to start working or start using Linux, you need to familiarize yourself more with this forest. That you can do from here. So this is called as the Linux Documentation Project, TLDP. So this website you can access. There are hundreds of tutorials. Figure out what actually you want. Try to learn step by step, and you download or view that particular tutorial and keep start going. So with this, I will stop for questions if you have. And before that, let me see how to make it
Thank you, Ramanu, for giving this lecture in a very lucid manner. I sincerely hope that everyone must have liked it, and we request you to keep giving lectures whenever you find time. Thank you.
Okay, if anyone has any question, you can ask. And if you are not having question right now, there is my mail ID. You can shoot me question. I owe this much to my institute, so I will find time to answer and guide you whatever capacity I am capable of. And I, if you want, I will share this presentation for your reference to respective authorities. You can contact them to get it. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.